What is the difference between XML and DITA? Well, in this video, we're going to dive into that and more. Hey there, my name is Josh, and over 10 years of experience in technical writing. I'm also the founder of Technical Writer HQ. Now, before we dive in this video, take a moment to subscribe to our channel, and that way you won't miss any of our future videos better explaining technical writing concepts like XML and DITA. Now, let's go ahead and get started. So we'll start with XML. And XML is a text-centric markup language derived from Standard Generalized Markup Language, or SGML. Moving to structured authoring with XML offers many benefits for documentation departments. However, moving from an unstructured authoring environment to a structured one requires effort and resources, is often time-consuming and can be expensive. Now, DITA is an XML-based open standard architecture for document representation, and DITA can help with making a move to structured authoring. An authoring paradigm presents technical writers with a particular view of the document model. There are two types of authoring paradigms, unstructured authoring and structured authoring. Now let's look at these two paradigms in more detail. Writers use unstructured authoring to create content according to rules and approved styles described in style guides. A style guide contains a documented approach on how the writing team is supposed to author content, including voice and tone, preferred writing style, number of heading levels, handling of images and documents, and punctuation, grammar, and spelling requirements. And editors double-check adherence to the approved style guide. And this manual process of ensuring style guide adherence is time-consuming. And authors use desktop publishing tools for the unstructured authoring of documents. And these tools, such as Microsoft Word, allow authoring and publishing from the same system. The tools integrate content and format, and the tool's graphical user interface, or GUI, is almost always what you see is what you get, or in other words, a WYSIWYG. And desktop publishing tools give writers control over content presentation and delivery. Structured authoring is a publishing paradigm that defines and enforces consistent information organization. And structured authoring incorporates things like systematic labeling. And systematic and consistent labeling allows easy identification of semantic elements by the readers. And a semantic element is an element of code that uses words to represent what the element contains in language that is easy for humans to understand. It also includes modular, topic-based architecture. And content is authored in topics, and each topic must make sense in its own right. And a topic is authored as a unit, not as part of a larger document. And topic-based authoring enables large-scale content reuse. Writers can assemble topics from a single pool or repository into different deliverable documents. You can use topics in different documents as long as it makes sense when read in different contexts. And topic-based writing makes translation and localization more efficient because a topic needs translation only once. And next, it includes constrained writing environments. Constraints aim to simplify the authoring process by reducing the complexity of an information type. And last here, it includes separation of content and form. Structured authoring separates content from presentation and delivery. Formatting and presentation are post-authoring considerations, and now let's look at an example to better understand the difference between unstructured and structured authoring. And this is the content hierarchy for a structured recipe. As you can see, the name comes before the ingredient list, which comes before the instructions. And structured authoring will maintain this hierarchical structure for the recipe. In an unstructured, formatted recipe, these relationships between the content elements are implied by how the type looks. For example, the recipe name will be in large bold type, and the ingredients will be in smaller type. And the publishing software will not enforce a content hierarchy, and the instructions can come before the ingredient list, for example. And structured authoring is a concept or paradigm. XML is a technology that you can use to implement structured authoring as well. Today, the terms structured authoring and XML are often used interchangeably. And XML is an acronym for extensible markup language. A markup language such as XML uses tags to define elements within a document. And tags are markup instructions enclosed in angle brackets. So for example, we have angle root angle and angle name angle. We can read a markup language because they contain standard words rather than programming code or syntax. And XML is used to store structured data rather than to format or display information on a page. And you can use XML to represent structured information for documents, books, data, manuscripts, and more. And an XML file is a plain text file with a .xml extension. To view and edit XML files, you can use a standard text editor or specialized XML editors. An XML editor can include tools for validating XML code, including parsing XML code and displaying XML, flagging text not enclosed within a tag, known as orphan text, and identifying improper tags. You can incorporate different types of content into an XML file. So for example, you can incorporate rich media content into XML through tags that identify the files in which a rich media content resides. And XML is an important development because of the following two reasons. XML overcomes inflexibility of and dependence on HTML, a single document type that was used for tasks it was not designed for. And XML overcomes the complexity of SGML, whose syntax allows several powerful but hard to program options. And XML allows the flexible development of user-defined document types. It provides a robust, non-proprietary, persistent, and verifiable file format for storing and transmitting text and data both on and off the web. It removes the more complex options of SGML, making it easier to program. And XML offers the following benefits for technical communicators. It has open standard, so XML is available as an open standard. And extensible, XML is an extensible markup and enables programmers to create custom tags for their applications and describe the tags in their permitted use cases. It also stores data. So XML does not participate in displaying data, it only carries the data. Essentially, it allows users to store data independently of how it will be presented. And then we have redundancy. XML markup is verbose. So for example, every end tag must be supplied, which enables computer programs to catch common errors such as incorrect nesting. And we have self-describing. The readability of XML and the presence of element and attribute names in XML means that writers looking at an XML document often find it easy to understand the format. This also makes it easy to find mistakes. And DITA is the acronym for Darwin Information Typing Architecture. It is an XML standard, an architectural approach, and a writing methodology. The Technical Publications Department at IBM developed DITA. In 2004, IBM donated DITA to the OASIS Standards Organization. The OASIS DITA Technical Committee now manages DITA, and DITA's features include modularity. With modular document development, topics can be reused, and any group of topics or elements can be treated as a modular document component. Instead of being created as one document, a large manual can be designed as a collection of different modules. And those modules can be arranged into different configurations to create different manuals. And modular manuals are easier to maintain and can be produced with efficiency. And then we have structured authoring. This defines and enforces consistent organization of information, which reduces authoring time and increases analysis time. And we have information typing. Information is structured by topics with content models appropriate to the nature of the content. And the three basic DITA information types are concept, task, and reference. And we also have minimalism, an approach that presents a reader with the smallest amount of information necessary to achieve the reader's goals. The needs of the reader or the learner, and not the system being documented, guide the information architecture and the writing style. Then we have inheritance. And this enables specialization of information types. The three base information types, so concept, task, and reference, evolve from the topic proto-information type, inherit the characteristics of a shared base structure. And we have topic-based. A topic-based architecture allows information reuse and makes translation and localization more efficient. And DITA defines four types of topics. So first is topic, which provides a generic structure for information. Then concept, which contains background information and examples. Next is task, which includes procedures. And then we have reference, which describes commands, parameters, and other features. And last here is metadata. A special DITA file called a map or DITA map is used to specify topics included in a deliverable document. The DITA map does not store content. It contains pointers to the topics that contain content. DITA offers several benefits for technical communicators. DITA relies on open standards. Free options like the DITA Open Toolkit eliminate licensing costs for proprietary tools. And the Open Toolkit provides paths to multiple output types by default. And DITA reduces content duplication and increases information reuse through modular writing. And the DITA structure has elements with similar names to corresponding HTML tags, reducing the learning curve for those familiar with HTML. And the growing adoption of DITA standards means more writers are familiar with it. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the most popular DITA implementation, the DITA Open Toolkit, or DITA-OT. And this is an open source publishing engine for content authored in DITA that IBM developed. The toolkit's extensible plugin mechanism allows users to add their own transformations and customize the default output. And several DITA authoring tools and DITA content management systems integrate the DITA open toolkit or parts of it into their own publishing workflows. And standalone tools have been developed to run the DITA OT via a graphical user interface instead of the command line. You can use a free DITA open toolkit to publish XML content, and you can also use commercial DITA implementations to publish content. And this is the content creation process for the DITA open toolkit. The toolkit includes the files that define the structure and XSL templates that transform XML content into outputs, including PDF, HTML, and online help. And even though the desktop publishing paradigm based on unstructured authoring is popular, it does have many disadvantages. So for example, when employees are asked to create materials for a presentation, each piece of the created content originates and resides in a different place throughout the organization. And over time, many duplicate content is created, and a lot of content becomes simply obsolete. And content that's scattered throughout the organization is difficult to find and difficult to maintain. Moreover, HR departments must create and maintain training material for the different desktop publishing platforms that employees prefer. And this time-consuming, inefficient, error-prone approach to content management is frustrating for individual employees and costly for organizations. For these reasons, organizations find that structured authoring with XML is a much more efficient and reliable way to generate, maintain, and publish content. And the shift to structured authoring with XML involves costs such as XML editor software, training, expertise, and process implementation. And this is where the use of DITA can help with making a move to structured authoring. And some documentation groups will find that DITA structure is a close match for their requirements, and they can bypass most of the content modeling effort by adopting the standard. And the free and popular DITA Open Toolkit contains all the files you need to implement a structured authoring environment based on the DITA standard. The toolkit includes the files that define the structure and the templates that transform the XML content into multiple output formats. And there you have it. We just went over everything from authoring paradigms, XML, DITA, and how DITA can help make a move to a structured authoring environment. And thank you for sticking with me all the way to the end of this lesson here. And again, my name is Josh. I'm the founder of Technical Writer HQ. And if you feel like you have a better understanding of the topic, make sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel for more information on technical writing and how to become a great technical writer. And I'll go ahead and see you in some of our following lessons. Cheers.